So hi everyone, welcome to Site247's webinar series. I'm Rohit and I'll be hosting this webinar today along with Ranjini, our product expert, and Ilango, our technical expert. Today's session will be on ACE, the digital end user experience. With that, the next part of the webinar will be taken by Ranjini. So over to you, Ranjini.
Thank you, Rohit. I'll be handling the webinar session today and we will be covering the rise of digital transformation, its impact on customer experience, and the importance of end-user monitoring. With that, let's move on to today's topic of discussion, digital transformation and end-user experience. Digital transformation is not something new. Ever since the advent of computers and mobile devices, the way we interact, communicate, and operate has significantly changed. The rise of cloud computing and artificial intelligence has only accelerated this process. Most of the organizations either operate from the cloud or in the process of transition. As we can see from the above stats, we can understand that the main objective of such transition is customer satisfaction. Let's look at the current pandemic. Even when everyone continues to work from home and the majority of the world is under lockdown, businesses and organizations find a way to cater to the consumer needs. For instance, conferences have become virtual meetings and online fitness apps have seen a spike due to the closing of gyms and so on. This substantiates the fact that customer experience forms the heart of any digital transformation. Also, today's Gen Z population demand instant gratification. Any form of slowness is definitely a turndown. Slowness is not only for digital native companies. Let's say you are a blogger. You could lose potential readers if your page is slow. If you are a news website and if people could not reach your site, you could lose your trust. So, slowness and downtime affects everyone invariably. In fact, it is estimated that on an average, the cost of downtime comes around $260,000 for enterprises for an hour. And that's a huge loss. But revenue loss is just the tip of the iceberg. There are other intangible losses that you could experience when your website becomes slow. For instance, the pressure to find out the root cause could lead to blame game and employee frustration. You also lose your brand name and reputation. You could also lose potential customers because of one disgruntled customer. So, how do you stay on top of your game? By ensuring that you deliver a seamless end-user experience. Wait, what do I mean by end-user experience? Is it another jargon? Simply put, end-user experience refers to how positive is your customer interaction with your websites or applications. Okay, so what does this translate to? This translates to your website availability, faster loading pages, no page timeout errors, and no application crashes. Sounds easy, isn't it? But how do you know that your customers have a positive user experience in real time? How do you measure them? Conventionally, how do we check it? We may check if our websites work or not by checking them from various browsers. Or in case, if a customer complains of a crash or unavailability, we fix them and revert back to our customers for their feedback. But the key is to identify these bottlenecks as and when they happen before the customers are impacted and ensure that they have a smooth user experience. This is where end-user monitoring comes handy. So, what is end-user monitoring? you understand and analyze how customers perceive your applications in real time. Even when your applications work fine, its performance could be hampered by various external factors. These factors could be network latencies or slow ISPs or browser-specific issues. So, even when your application works fine, your customers may not have an ambient experience. This is where end-user monitoring comes handy. With end-user monitoring, you can analyze your website availability, optimize your front-end performance, also analyze your application responsiveness depending upon the traffic, and also get real-time and historical data on customer behavior. You can also set thresholds for various parameters, get alerted beforehand, and proactively resolve issues even before your end users are affected. But wait, end user monitoring is not just about metrics. By vigilantly monitoring and analyzing, you can unearth various factors like what is the customer trend, what is their demography, when are they likely to visit the site? You can tailor your marketing efforts accordingly. And how does your website perform during busy hours? How does it handle peak traffic? So, to sum up, end-user monitoring is not just about metrics. It helps you understand your customer behavior and application performance and enables you to correlate both. Let's look at an example. VTitan.com is a med healthcare provider. VTitan caters to providing high-end medical equipments for critical needs. VTitan is an emerging market leader and wants to nail the end-user experience to stay on top of the game. So, here, what all factors should VTitan take into account to do so? First and foremost is website availability. VTitan's website should be accessible to visitors and customers at any time from any place. Also, he or she must have a fair understanding of various factors that hinder the website performance. The user navigation across the website should also be seamless. He or she must also know how the site performs during peak traffic conditions and how to optimize it accordingly. VTitan should also ensure that the website is optimized for mobile and should be secure enough from hacking or phishing attempts. Here's where Site24/7 comes into play. Let's analyze the above set factors one by one. Let's first address website availability, performance, and security. With Site24/7 website monitoring, you can ping and see your website availability for every 1 minute. You can check it from more than 110 plus global locations. Let's say you are hosted in Australia, but your customer base is in the United States. In this case, you can choose the United States as your primary location that needs to be monitored. You can also choose secondary and tertiary monitoring locations. This comes handy in case if your website is not available in your primary location. In this case, Site24/7 checks from the other two chosen locations, and only when your website is down from all the three places, you will receive an alert. This ensures that there is no false alert. Not only that, you can also monitor the time taken by each component of your website, like the time taken by various HTML elements and scripts. This enables you to determine if these components pull you down in the SEO ladder. Since half the traffic comes from mobile these days, the API endpoints also needs to be checked. With Site24/7 REST API monitoring, you can monitor the endpoints, the latency in the communication, if any. Apart from this, You can also set alerts to receive timely notifications before your domain or SSL certificate gets expired. This gives you enough room to renew your certificates. Not only that, you can also protect your websites from phishing attacks. Say, if someone tries to inject any malicious code or SQL queries, you will receive real-time alerts regarding it and you can take immediate action. Let me just navigate to the Site24/7 client to show you how this works in real time. Now, the summary tab shows you the overall response time for a chosen time period and the various components and their individual response time and how they contribute or its effect on the overall response time. And not only that, you can also check the availability and response time from the chosen global locations. And as I said, you can also inspect and see if any one particular component slows down your entire website. In this case, as I scroll down, you can see there are two particular HTML elements which has contributed to the overall spike in the response time. And speaking of SSL certificate expiry or domain expiry, you can customize the date or time period before which you want to receive an alert and promptly renew them. And last but not the least, coming to the phishing attacks, this is where the website defacement monitor from Site24/7 comes handy. So how this works is, the defacement monitor baselines all your content and other elements of your website, like say your text, script, images, anchors, or iframes. So whenever any of these elements show a change or exceed the set threshold, it automatically alerts you. Let me just show you the RC of one such defacement example. So as you can see from this example, the script has been visibly modified, and in this case, Site24/7 defacement monitor sends you an alert in real time, and this helps you to immediately look if there is a phishing or hacking attempt on your website. To summarize, website availability, performance, and security are taken care by Site24/7 website monitoring. Moving on to the next part, seamless user navigation. The main concern here is to understand that there are no broken pages or hiccups when a user navigates through the website or when the user tries to interact with your website. This is taken care by Site24/7 synthetic monitoring. Synthetic monitoring is also known as real browser monitoring. Synthetic monitoring allows you to monitor the entire transaction path taken by a user. This comes handy when a user performs various actions like filling out a form or adding a product in the cart and makes payment via online payment gateways. The real browser monitor basically consists of a recorder tool. You can record the critical transactions, simulate and monitor them from various global locations in various browsers. You can also poll and check at frequent intervals according to your needs. If you have Selenium test cases in your production environment, you can also upload them and the RBM recorder will automatically record and check for those use cases too. Navigating to the client. So, Site24/7 RBM recorder is available for Windows, Mac OS, and it is also available as a Chrome extension. Let me just show you a demo as how the Chrome extension works. So, the Chrome extension works like any other Chrome extension. You just choose your data center and click to record a new transaction. In this case, I will try doing some transactions from the WeTitan website itself. I just key in the URL and click on start recording. And as you can see, the RBM recorder tries to monitor or tries to record every interaction that I perform in the website. Every mouse click or every navigation or every transition across the URLs is being recorded by the RBM recorder. I then go back and see if all the steps of the critical transactions are recorded. So once I record it, I can choose to configure the various other parameters, like how much time should the recorder wait for the page to load, or how much time should the recorder wait or allow between two successive transactions. I can also choose if this should be simulated and played back from any of the browser types. You can also set global locations, or in case if you are monitoring your internet applications, like say your CRM or payroll app, you can choose to do so with the help of Site24/7 on-prem polling. So once you configure all these parameters, the Site24/7 synthetic recorder does a playback from the chosen location and sends the data to the Site24/7 client. Moving on to the client to show what kind of metrics is being captured. As you can see, the response time taken for every individual transaction is recorded and displayed here. And not only that, the response time for every individual transactions across the chosen global locations is also listed out. And in case of any bottlenecks or hiccups or an outage, Site24/7 automatically takes a screenshot, and this enables you to see if there is any outage at a glance. With that, we have seen an overview of how Site24/7 can help you ensure seamless user navigation. Hope all of you are with me, and assuming that, I proceed further. Now that we have understood how website performance, availability, security, and navigation can be monitored, we will look into how front-end performance can be optimized in real time. This is where Site24/7 real user monitoring comes handy. With RUM, you can understand the impact of external factors like network latencies, slow ISPs, and how they impact your customer experience in real time. Not only that, you can optimize your front-end performance too. Understand how the various resources, say CSS, images, or scripts, or content from third-party domains, impact the overall response time. You can also analyze the performance of individual web pages in your website. In case of single-page applications like Angular, Ember, or React, you can also check the performance of AJAX calls and JavaScript errors. Not only that, you can also understand individual user sessions and optimize them accordingly. Moving on to the client to explain this further. I'm just navigating to the Real User Monitoring tab in Site24/7. And as you can see, this is the global user experience across various regions for your application for the chosen time period. So from this geographic map, we can infer that customers in Middle East have a good user experience, whereas customers across United States and Canada have a good to moderate user experience, while the customers in Australia have a poor experience. You can also click on individual geographies to see if this has been the performance trend over the period or if there is any outlier. You can also click on individual location to see the time series data and conclude further. In case if you have done any performance enhancements or optimizations, you can click on the playback button to see how the customer experience has varied over the chosen time period. Clicking on the ISP tab shows me how the website response time has varied over the ISPs that are being accessed by my end user. So in this case, I can say that the website response time lies on an average of around 1000 to 2000 milliseconds. But in some cases, I can see there is a spike to a maximum of 10 to 11 seconds. You can drill down further to see if this is an outlier or if there is any problem with the ISP vendor. The device type gives an idea as to what kind of devices is my website or application is being accessed from. So, as seen in this above chart, I can understand that a chunk of my users come from Android applications. So, this will help me in putting responsiveness as my top priority. And as I mentioned earlier, every individual URL or web page that is being accessed by your customer is monitored with RAM. Let me just click on any URL to show you further. And for every URL, you can see the response time as well as the response time splitter. And if it is a single page application, you can also see the AJAX calls involved in that particular URL, the response time of individual AJAX calls, and 200 or 400 errors, if any. And the top hits just shows me where this URL is being frequently accessed from and in what kind of devices. This will help me tailor my marketing effort. By clicking on similar transactions, you can analyze the response time taken by the same URL to various customer or user IDs, and you can drill down and optimize further. Navigating through the JavaScript errors, as you can see, for the last 7 days alone, I can see a total of 300 errors. I can just click on any filter and see what kind of errors I want to debug. I can then click on the errors to see their exact stack trace, that is the exact line in which the error has occurred. In case of a minified JavaScript file, you can also upload your source map and debug the exact line of error. The breadcrumb is nothing but the user navigation path where the user has encountered this error. You can replicate this entire transaction path in your production environment and troubleshoot the errors with ease. You can also click on error instances to have a fair understanding of the other places where this error might have occurred. Moving on to the snapshots tab. So every time when your website exceeds the set threshold limit, a snapshot is automatically taken from Site24/7. So this helps you understand the entire user session that has occurred over at that particular point of time. As you can see, the start and end time of the user session is recorded here, and the page on time for every page that has been visited in this session is also shown. And not only that, for every page, you also get granular details like the domain info, the various kind of resources that were called for the page to load, and the resources with the maximum loading time and that had an impact on the overall website response time spike. So this will enable you to troubleshoot in real time and resolve problems immediately. To summarize, with Site24/7 website synthetic and real user monitoring, you can optimize the end user experience. But as I said earlier, monitoring is not only about metrics. And with Site24/7, you can do more. Let's look at the various features that make monitoring easy. The root cause analysis report is not like your conventional downtime report. The RCA report enables you to understand what actually triggered the downtime. It shows the result as what happened when trying to check from multiple locations and the conclusion. You also get to see the trace route, the hops made in between while trying to reach your website, and failures, if any, and helps you understand why the outage occurred in the first place. Site24/7 is powered by a robust AI engine. The AI engine baselines the website's normal performance and alerts when there is a slight deviation or spike in response time. Let us say your website response time has become high suddenly. This could be because of a backend issue or a high customer usage. In any case, the AI engine triggers an alert, and this helps you to analyze and resolve the bottlenecks even before it surfaces. With Site24/7 custom dashboards, you can cherry pick the key metrics like the total response time of your website, the live status of all your monitors, the geography map, etc. This helps your ops or IT teams to have a quick glance about the status and functioning of your website. In case of an inevitable downtime or an outage, you can communicate the status of your service unavailability to your customers. Whenever an outage occurs, an incident is triggered, and this is communicated to customers directly with the help of status pages. This ensures transparency and helps build trust with customers, and also reduces the escalation of calls to a help desk. Thus, to summarize, you can have a holistic monitoring of end-user experience with Site24/7. But wait, if you think Site24/7 caters only to end-user monitoring, let me correct you. With Site24/7, you get a 360-degree view of your entire infrastructure and application health. You can monitor and optimize the performance of your applications built on various platforms like AWS, Azure, or Google Cloud platforms. You can also monitor the performance of your physical servers, virtual machines, Dockers, and containers. You can monitor the network devices like SNMP and routers. This gives you complete visibility into your entire application architecture and helps you troubleshoot easily. Site24/7 app is also available in Android and iOS platforms. This helps you to receive alerts and notifications on the go. Any collaboration or communication tool you depend on, Site24/7 integrates with ease. You can route notifications easily to Slack, automatically create and update tickets in Jira, and manage engine service desk plus. You can also trigger and resolve incidents in PagerDuty, Zapier, and ServiceNow. The list does not end here. We keep adding them to make conversations easier and smoother for you. Hope you found this webinar to be informative and interesting.